Tonight's first opening is Battle Axe Fest Beer from Brazen Hall Brewing Company in Winnipeg. This strong lager is designed to showcase the paler malts with just a touch of hops while still quenching your thirst. Crackery malt sweetness with a touch of bitterness on the back end. It's a very nice malty taste for a lager. I also didn't expect that. I should have read the can more, but whatever. It's always good to try new things. So let's get into this pile of things over here. What do we have first on the agenda? It says it is DC037 RGB. Intriguing. LEDs? Probably. Possibly. Or a complete lie? It is LEDs. So at first glance, it looks a lot like the kind of a thing you could just get at a dollar store. You know, like this one here, which I did get at a dollar store. The difference being, this one just has one color of LED in its string. This guy claims to be RGB. And it's got a bunch of patterns and things on here too. And it comes with a remote control. Well, let's go check the listing on this and then I'll throw some batteries in it and see what it does. 10 meters, LED copper light string fairy garden power lamp party wedding decoration. 10 meters, wow. I got this from Nimarajap underscore zero. Oh, a seller with only five feedbacks to their name. Interesting. Small seller. I got this at auction for $4.10 Canadian with free shipping. So that puts it at a fairly low risk, even if it was a new seller and even if it turned out to be crap. At the bare minimum, it's got a bunch of LEDs and an IR remote control with it. See, our 2025 battery not included. So three double A's in there. Wow, that's actually a gasketed case. That's surprising. And the little button's got a gasket over it too. Okay. So, push the button. Hey, that's pretty cool. Push the button a second time. Slightly different pattern. To my naked eyes, that thing is just fading in, but obviously what you're seeing on the camera is a lot of PWM. That's flashing pretty much how it looks. Again, that's PWMing. It's a lot smoother in person. Whoa, that's seizure inducing. Steady on. That is actually solid on in the real world. And then there is off. Okay, just like it says on there. And the remote, in fact, did not come with a battery. It wants a 2025, but a 2032 seems to fit in there. So let's see. Where is the IR sensor going to be? Can I see it from in here? Not right. Oh, there it is right there. Okay. And you see that? It's this guy right here. There's a little 8-pin chip and not much else in there. Anyway, so if we turn this on, hey, it works. So the remote control actually does what it says it does. Let me change modes here. Yeah, that's working pretty well. Well, I can dim and brighten it. Let's go into mode 8. No. Which mode was solid on? 8? Yeah. Okay, that is actually steady on. Just the PWM is messing with you. So if I brighten it up, if I dim it down a little bit here, can you see that that's dimming? I can see this dimming. That's a cool little thing. Probably come in handy for Christmas decorating time. And it claims to be 10 meters. But there is one wrap there. And that is 20 centimeters. Yeah, that probably is a full 10 meters in there, just doing a rough count of the coils, huh? Okay, next thing in. This thing's heavy. It says roller skates bearing. That's possible. It is bearings. Okay. They're all goopy with grease. That's good, I guess. And they are 608ZZ, which are skateboard bearings. They're fairly stiff. That's with the grease that's in them. Yee. That shouldn't be hard to clean off the outside. Now then, the reason that I got these is not because I'm taking up skateboarding. What these are actually for is a filament spool holder for my 3D printer, which I printed out a long time ago when I actually ordered these. So these things come in to pairs. Let's get this skirt off here, or brim, I mean. So these bearings shove onto there. There should be a friction fit onto one side. Yeah. So if I printed these things correctly, they should hold together just as a snap fit, and then the spool sits on there. I may have to glue these on, or glue these together, but anyway, spool sits on there and it just rolls. So the standard filament holder that comes with most printers, including mine, is basically just a stick that goes through the hole, which is fine, but then it has to be mounted off the side rail of the printer somehow, whereas this can be just put on the counter someplace or the table and do its job. So it looks like I didn't print this with quite the right tolerances. That one sits in there nicely, but that one sits in there nicely. Okay. Yeah, I may have to glue it, or actually just put a piece of tape across the bottom, I guess, to hold it together.
10 pieces ABEC 7608ZZ skate scooter skateboard wheels, spare bearings, ball roll, blah, blah, blah. Got these from Lily Bell? Sure. Free shipping, of course, because that's how I prefer to go. Back when I bought them, whenever that was, it was $5 even Canadian. Now it has gone up to $6.32. Searching for that type of bearing will find you all manner of sellers and all manner of qualities of them, too. I mean, nothing unexpected down here. They're steel, they're deep groove ball bearings, they're less friction, higher speeds. Woohoo!
What is this? I don't know what this is because it came from the Canadian reshipping warehouse. Okay, this is some toothed belting. Some people call it timing belt. But it is very commonly used in homemade CNC projects and 3D printers and whatnot. And I hope that's the size that I would need should I have to replace it on my 3D printer. Not that I'm expecting it to break, but maybe it'll stretch over time or something. Or I could use it for my own projects, which is why I bought one that came with a couple of the pulleys. Yeah, I think that's what they're called. They're not gears, even though they're toothed. Okay, and those shaft sizes. Are they the right shaft size? Oh, they are. They fit just nicely onto these stepper motors that I was sent last year sometime. Yeah, these fit quite nicely onto the stepper motors that Dan sent me last year. Very good. Well, I can see some projects coming there.
BIQU, two pieces, GT2-6mm open timing belt, 20 teeth bore, 5/8mm pulley with 2 meters PU steel. Yeah, I got this from BIQU. I guess that's how you pronounce it. And I got the 5mm bore. They also have an 8. Bore being the shaft size on the pulleys. And yeah, that's what it cost me back when I bought it, $5.86 with free shipping. So it says it's got 2 meters of the belting, steel timing belt, steel and rubber timing belt. No, timing belt is type A rubber. That's what I got. Fits for various 3D printing and whatnot projects. Yeah, GT2. That is the tooth pitch, tooth profile on the belt and on the pulleys. And that is a common project that you can print out just about any tooth size you want. The pulleys that come with it are 20 teeth, so if you print a larger one, you can slow things down and get more torque. You print a smaller one, you can get more speed. Although I don't know if you want to go that much smaller, it might get just mechanically awkward.
So next in is another one that came in from the reshipping warehouse in Mississauga. So no idea what it is. Oh, it's got a note and one of these little goosenecky USB lights. I know I've bought those before, but I don't think I've bought one recently. They're nice and bright and all. Kind of interesting. I think Julian Islet got a whole bunch of them and used them as a funky little LED sculpture. And it's kind of neat for reading in bed or something, I guess. If you're, you know, not reading your phone. What does the note say? I just had to pause for a second to censor a couple of email addresses on here. Interesting. So Ranpo Lighting is inviting me to join some kind of a review program. Huh. They will send free test product to test before selling once available. Oh, and they've already shipped my last order. It's not this one. Okay. That's interesting. Would you guys be interested in seeing what I could get out of these guys for demos and samples and stuff just to play with? I'm always a little bit conscious about looking like I'm selling out, but I don't know. Let me know. And the fifth and final envelope for today. This one says it's a keyboard. Well, small for a keyboard, don't you think? Oh, it's one of this kind of keyboard. Okay. A little 4x4 matrix keyboard. These things are relatively common in our Arduino world. Basically, the wires coming out, there's four columns and four rows. And if you push a button, it joins one column with one row. And your Arduino or whatever microcontroller you got on there just scans through the pins and identifies where there's a closed circuit. It's a super easy way of getting, you know, 8 pins to read 16 buttons. And I think this backing on here, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, it is. It's an adhesive. So that can mount just flat on the top of your project, cut a little slit in the top of your box and drop it in there. Make it look nice and slick and professional if you did it right.
For Arduino, AVR, PIC, 4x4, matrix, array, keyboard, 16-key, membrane, switch, keypad, DIY. Got this one at auction from Jasmine056. I paid $1.89 with free shipping. So for a single one, they tend to be in the $3 to $5 kind of a range. But if you buy them in bulk, you can see up here, you can get them for two-ish dollars each, give or take. So I didn't save too much money, but I figured throw my hat in the auction. Why not? Yeah, there's the one-off price from various other places. Seemed like a good idea at the time, and you never know when you're going to want something like this for a project.
And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Interesting assortment of electronic and mechanical bits and pieces this time. The shipping times, the RGB remote control kind of thing here took 38 days. The matrix keyboard took 31 days. The bearings, what did they take? The bearings took 69 days from China. And the belting and pulleys took 16 days, coming from the Canadian warehouse, of course. And this thing and the invitation to, well, I don't know how long it took because I didn't order it. So anyway, yeah, there we go. Interesting assortment and an interesting proposition from this company. I'm not sure whether I'm going to take them up on it or not, though. As you may have noticed, I don't do a lot of sponsored content. I did a little bit last year, but I don't know. What do you think about that offer? I'm still not quite sure whether I should take them up on it or not. Anyways, questions, comments, down below as usual. Thanks for watching. Thanks to my Patreon supporters who help me afford this stuff and buy me some beers now and again. I truly appreciate you guys. Yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. I will talk to you later.